Bonjour! Hi! Welcome in this new episode of Cloud in 5 Minutes. I'm Frank Boucher, and today I want to talk about how and why you should use Azure Active Directory, AAD, with Blazor WebAssembly. It's often the case when we build web app, we want the user to be authenticated. It's very useful, and then we know who we are talking to. I show you in a previous episode, the link will be over there, episode 56, how to use social media, so Twitter, Facebook, Google, all the others to get authenticated. But then anybody can get in your app. And sometimes we just want a selection or some people to get in. And that's why Azure Active Directory is very good for that. First, you already have it. If you have Azure, there's an AD for you inside over there. So it's kind of free. Also, Azure Active Directory will give you the permission to have roles and groups and all those things so you could have permission very granular that could help you to have a better control inside your web app. If you stay until the end, I will show you how to do it and I will also provide a few links to get you started to learn more. But for today, what I want to do is create a WebAssembly, a Blazor WebAssembly, and use Azure Active Directory for a login. Let's get started. So here we are in the Azure portal. So what I want to do now is go inside my Azure Active Directory and create an application registration. This way, my application will have an identity and will be able to question my Azure Active Directory. So to do that, you just need to go and search for Active Directory. I have it already in the bar, so we'll click on it. And now what I'm looking for, it's here, it's app registration. So we'll click this and I will create a new app registration. So it's the new button here. I just give it a name. Put something that makes sense for you. At the end, you could have many different apps, so try to be creative, but at the same time, make something that is meaningful. Then you have many different options that are offered to you. The one we are looking today is here, that one where we'll go for a single tenant. It's our own Azure Active Directory. It could be useful if you have multiple Azure AD and you're using synchronization or you want to invite people from an Azure, another Active Directory to use multi-tenant and of those one. But for today, we'll keep it simple and use single tenant. The redirect URL, it's important to put something there so once you're registered, you will get back to your application. Since I will just be running the app right now on-prem, I won't deploy in Azure. I will use here localhost 5001 because I know by default that's the port that .NET will publish locally my application. And then I have authentication and login callback. That URL will change depending on where your application is and what type of application it is. So you could put any valid URL here. And that's it. So for now, I just need to register. Okay, one extra step we need to do is here, go back in the authentication. And here we have the URL we just added or specified. You can add other ones. So if you're deploying, working locally and deploying it in your dev environment, you could totally have multiple links here, by the way. So here, what we want to do is click here, check that access token and ID tokens. So it will help us when we try to get more information. Don't forget to save. And I'll just go back. So now the important part here is to grab some ID identifier and keep that on the side because we'll need it in the next step. So the two IDs I need are the client ID. This is this client registration that I just created. That's the ID for it. And the tenant ID, that's your Azure Active Directory. So this one will be probably the same for each application inside that subscription. And this one, the first one, will change every time. So copy paste that somewhere, we'll need it in the next step. Okay, so now I want to create my .NET application. I could go in Visual Studio, the big one, the big IDE, but let's play today with Visual Studio Code, so I will create my application with the terminal, you know, just for fun. So I open my terminal and I will paste the command and I will explain it to you. So here I have .NET new, Blazor WebAssembly. That's because I want to create a WebAssembly. So WebAssembly, what it is, if you didn't know yet, it's in C# but client-side without JavaScript. So pretty cool. And then what I want to do here is pass the authentication single org, just like we configure in our Azure Active Directory. And then I will specify my client ID that we just got and my tenant ID here. And then I specify the name and the folder where I want to create that application. So I just need to do this. It will take a few seconds and then the app will be done. So I will just change directory to go where my app was just created. So I'll go in cloud, 5 minutes, WebAssembly. Whoops, it was there. Voila. And now we'll open Visual Studio Code. So code with a dot. It opened Visual Studio Code in that specific folder. So here we are inside Visual Studio Code. So what I want to do right now is show you what was created for us. So of course, here I have the default application. And if I go in the www root, I could go here in the app settings. And if I click, I have here my Azure Active Directory information that was there for me. There's no problem having that in a repository since this is just an ID. It's not a user or password. Everything is still in Azure, very secure. Now let's try it locally. So I will F5 just to run locally with the debug mode. Here it is. We can see the top right corner. I'm not authenticated yet. I can navigate through the application, so I could see the fetch data, go encounter, the click me, increment the things. And now let's get authenticated. So I will click the login link here, enter my credential. And now because it's the first time I'm trying to authenticate it, I need to give the permission because I'm saying, hey, I want to give the permission. And depending on what you are looking for, the list of the permission here could be different. So just say, yes, I consent and accept. So now we can see I'm authenticated just here and I can still access to all the pages. So now let's see what else can we do. So we'll close this, shut down here. Now let's say the page with the counter. I would like to have only people who are authenticated to have access because maybe you have sections of your web app that are public and others not that much. So what you can do now is go to that page. So I just go open the page and I will go to the counter. And to get the authenticated, the only thing I need to do here is add the attribute authorize. But if I'm trying that, I will get an error. I need to add a library. So let's do that right now. I will open the terminal just like this. Let's clear the screen so it's very clear what I'm adding. And I want to do here the command .NET add package. And it's the Microsoft ASP.NET Core authorization library that I want to add. Run this. And now I have all the information for me. I just need to add a reference, of course. Perfect, so I can close that terminal. And to add the reference, I just need here to go and specify using Microsoft ASP.NET Core authorization. And now if I'm trying to run that, I won't have any error. So let's try again and see the difference. So we'll press F5 again. As you can see, I'm not logged in yet. So let's go in fetch data. So fetch data work as expected. Now by clicking to counter, I should have automatically a request to get authenticated. So if I click counter here, click my authentication, enter my password, and now I'm in. Perfect, I could. So that's excellent. Now, what if I'm using some kind of role. So maybe only an administrator could access to this page or something like that. So even if I'm authenticated, I won't have access to some area, or maybe the menu will be different. How could we do that? So let's log out first. We'll log out this client. Excellent. Good idea. Close the browser. Excellent. Now we'll stop this. So let's say it's the counter page is reserved for the administrator. So what I can do here is just add some policies, and here I'm adding administrator, just like that. It could be way more complex, and you could also have different view depending if the user is authenticated or not. To have an example of how we could quickly have their friend view, you could get inspiration. If you go into the shared folder, there's the login display, and as we were authenticated or not, we were seeing hello with the username or logged in. So here, this is how you do it with the authorized view, where the authorized, you will see this message, and with not authorized, you will see another message. So that's how you could have different part of the menu visible or not. But for now, we'll keep it simple, and I should just not have enough permission now to be able to see counter. So let's try that one more time. Oops. Perfect. So let's log in right away. Okay, so now I am logged in, but and if I go to fetch data, it's still working. Of course, it doesn't require anything. And now if I go to counter, I should have the page, but empty. Exactly, saying you are not authorized to see this resource. Voila, it's all done. We don't have to manage the forget password and user creation and all those things and make it secure. And it's all done for us in Azure Active Directory, and it's all accessible to the portal. I promise you links to get started and learn more. But before I do that, if you appreciate this video, I would love you if you give it a thumbs up, and also if you leave a comment to ask a question or just give some feedback. It's always very appreciated. But now let's go for the link. So I have two links for you. So the first one is really documentation, how to get started. So the link will appear in the screen, and it's everything that I share with you today in details with the command and all the settings for you. The second link I have for you, it's a Learn module. So Learn, Microsoft Learn, it's a very, very well, it's completely free documentation to learn and get some certification. This one specifically talk about Blazor WebAssembly. WebAssembly was just announced recently during Microsoft Ignite event. It's really fun. You could do a tons of stuff. So have a look. This module take only 45 minutes. So very fun to do. I hope you liked this video. I hope it was helpful. Don't forget, subscribe and share. I will see you in the next one. Thank you. Still there? Super. I would like to add, I'm streaming live coding on Twitch. So twitch.tv/fbucheros, and 2 times a week, so on Wednesday and Friday, for 2 hours, I'm there building different application, open source, talking with you, answering your question. Come, it's super fun. twitch.tv/fbucheros. See you there. Bye.